Tonight on The Road Home.
There's a cop, Everyone sit tight.
Blink 182. Join San Diego's favorite punkster pranksters as they take you on a so cool tour of their SoCal roots.
This is my high school right here. They kicked me out of school.
Meet the Runts.
That's my boy! That's my boy!
Chow down. And hitch a ride as we uncover the band's road to success that took them from all the small things to lots of big things.
Then I'm like, Dad, buy the house.
And finally, a secret hometown show for friends, family, and you.
We're just moments away from taking the stage and making total asses out of ourselves.
Hi, my name is Tom.
My name is Mark.
My name is Travis.
We are Blink 182.
Okay, we're going to take you to where it began. Tom's going to take you to his mom's house, and I'm going to take you over to my mom's house to show you where we grew up and how we were living back in the day when I was a teenager, before I had status and before Tom had a pager. See you guys later.
San Diego's just a great place. The people are nice.
San Diego to me is rad because it's like you have the best of all things. You have like the convenience of a large city, then you have the beaches, and you have the best weather.
San Diego means home, and my dogs, and my chick, and both of my friends, and I like my home.
We're gonna be driving through my hometown of Poway, San Diego, California. I can tell you my little stories of my youth, my childhood. Okay, this street here, this is Twin Peaks. We would run across it naked at night. See, I got lots of stories. Right here on this corner, we shot my friend with a paintball gun when he was riding home on his bike and he fell off and popped his tire and didn't know why, he didn't know what happened. This is my mother,
Hi.
Connie. This is me, Tom. And we are at my house that I grew up in. 6th through 12th grade. We don't know what kind of creepy people live here now. Behind this garage door here is where a lot of the guitar playing went on. A lot of me learning how to play guitar.
My first guitar was given to me by my friends Nate and Mike Haney.
Yeah, I gave Tom his first guitar. My dad was a trash man for the city of San Diego, and someone threw an old guitar out, so I gave it to Tom for his birthday. I don't even know how old we were, like 15, 16. He never stopped playing the stupid guitar.
Enough! Could you just cut out the guitar?
I used to tell him he sucked all the time.
That didn't stop Tom. He just kept trying and trying.
And then from that day forward, the only thing I cared about was skateboarding and music.
Every waking moment, if he had 5 minutes between now and work, he'd be in there punking this guitar.
Those people over there used to call them, they called the cops because we were really loud.
We could never be friends with those people.
My mom was cool, except when she caught me drinking. I went to a basketball game. And apparently you're not supposed to down a bunch of whiskey before you go to these things at school. And I was fine, but one of my friends fell on his face.
Tom was into a lot of things. You know, he never kept us bored.
And then they kicked me out of high school. But that was a good thing, because when I went to the new high school, Mark's sister was dating one of my best friends, and I met Mark.
It was love at first sight, absolutely. They just are made for each other.
My sister's like, hey, you gotta meet this guy named Tom. He plays guitar and he's looking to put together a band.
I walked into a garage and he was playing these punk rock songs on bass guitar, so I was like, wow, I'm all, finally, somebody likes the same music as me.
First thing we did as a band was start practicing with Scott, our first drummer.
So we came over here to play for the first time, so we went into the garage.
And Mark decided that he was gonna bust out his party trick, you know, that he was gonna climb the streetlight in front of Tom's house.
And I just met him. I'm like, what are you doing climbing a lamp pole?
He got it all the way up.
And they jumped off and cracked both of his heels, and he's on crutches for like the next 3 weeks.
He was so sure he was gonna impress Tom and look really cool.
They were just like, you're an idiot, what are you doing?
Neither one of them has ever grown out of junior high.
We both have the same sense of humor.
Poop, poop, caca, ooh.
We both like the exact same style of music.
We get in an argument and 2 minutes later, it's like, hey man, like what you said really hurt me, my feelings, and like, you know, we totally talk it out like we're dating or something, it's bad.
We just clicked immediately. What's my age again?
Let's get out of here.
My sister introduced Tom and I the day after I moved to San Diego because we were going to start writing songs. So I went over to his house, and to sum up Tom in one word from first impression, it would be feminine. Okay, I'm going to take you to my mom's house. My mom's been probably the biggest Blink supporter since day one. This is where I lived during the genesis of Blink 182. This is the house that wrote songs in. This is the bedroom that I wrote songs in. This is where our first drummer lived with us for a year. Here we are. Mom.
Hi.
And here she is. What's up? How you doing?
Hi. Welcome home. Welcome.
Show them around. Show them all the cool stuff. This is the room. Tell them this is what used to be my room.
It's changed a lot since then. Imagine just nothing but posters and on the walls and clothes on the floor.
There's my Nana.
Hi.
Now, if you had to rate my butt on a scale of 1 to 10 from the What's Magikin video, what would you rate my butt? Do I have a nice butt or what?
A wonderful butt.
There you go.
I used to die for it.
That's right. Oh, enough of you. Okay. This is the bathroom where we used to dial our hair when we were growing up. Green and purple and stuff. It's also the bathroom where Tom learned to go pee-pee standing up like a big boy.
I want to say straight out from the front that nobody was ever allowed to swear or cuss in our family. Ever. They weren't even allowed to say butt, like move your butt.
The first t-shirts we ever made, we screened in my mom's garage ourselves.
You couldn't even walk back there. It smelled like bleach and ink and chemicals.
I searched around and came up with their old silk screen board. And this is one of the designs that Tom had made for t-shirts.
A lot of what happened in the early days was staged out of my mom's living room or my mom's garage.
Over the years, I've been collecting as I can a lot of Blink paraphernalia. It started off, I had just one little album, and now I've just got so many things. Posters, here's an old record. This was the very first demo tape they ever did.
You know, we folded all the inserts on our floor.
When time came to put it together, everybody in the family had to help.
We'd have a whole little assembly line set up, and you know, we'd be passing them around while we were watching TV.
One wonderful memory that I have from the old days is that there was always music playing, and it was so much fun to be around them. They were so creative and noisy, and I learned a lot of the songs too. My mom's not a woman anymore. She dresses like a man.
How rad is that? My mom will sing a song about transvestites. See, I'm not the strange one.
Bye-bye.
See you later. Bye-bye.
See you soon.
Let's go find out what Tom's doing.
I got kicked out of Poway High School for drinking.
This is the first time back here since I graduated in 93. It's weird. I feel like I could get in trouble for nothing.
We're going to go see my sister.
My pretty little sister, Carrie. She's a senior. She's beautiful.
There's my sister.
I didn't tell you were coming.
I'm here to invite you to our small little intimate show on Wednesday night.
I'll go.
Hey, look at that. I wish dates were that easy when I was here.
We're going to the front of the school here to find one of my old teachers, Mr. Reese. He was by far probably the raddest teacher I had. I don't even know if he really remembers me.
All right, it's good to see you, Pat. How are you?
Mr. Reese. Tom was this really shy and introverted kind of guy, you know, and I figure he's hanging around now because homecoming's about a week away. And
I gotta get
probably,
a date.
Yeah, you want to get a date for that again. But this guy, you were a homecoming king, weren't you?
I think all my friends voted for me as a way to spite the principals and deans of the school. I think that's why I won, maybe kind of the... Going off. I wrote this right here. It says Blink. I wrote that. It says Tom DeLonge. It says 93.
I'm happy to see you doing so well.
Yeah. Well, thanks for letting us come in your class.
Anytime. Thanks for showing up.
Hey, good to take it easy.
It really is.
Get back to work.
Yeah, get back to work.
There's a few detention issues that weren't cleared out.
This is so funny. Sally's notorious for being like the head person that always gives out the detention.
I'm the hammer.
She is. Nice seeing you again.
Okay, nice seeing you.
Be nice
too.
To the kids. The kids don't know any better.
Okay. And I heard about that song you wrote about me. I guess that wasn't a good thing.
Hey, everything's a good thing if you're in one of our songs.
Oh.
That's what I said.
Okay.
I had no idea I'd even come back here selling records and with a TV crew, but it's weird.
You feel dumb or?
Yeah.
I feel dumb.
Coming up, old haunts and hallowed hangouts.
This is my Graceland.
Plus, go backstage and on stage with the band for a rare club gig.
I don't want to cuss because my mom's here.
It's the Mark, Tom, and Travis Hometown Show.
We're going to hook up with Tom and see what he's doing, and he's going to join in on the tour of Blink 182 history in San Diego.
Are we taking a separate car?
No, hopping my ride.
Your rental?
Tacoma was the place that Blink-182 really started. That was the place where all the punk rock bands played in San Diego, and it was all ages, which we wanted to be involved with. And I mean, we just grew up pretty much going to that place and watching bands play there. So like our biggest goal was to play Soma.
When I really felt like Mark and Blink were doing really well was that when they were actually, they actually played a big show at Soma.
I remember coming out and sitting on the stage right to the left of my brother and just sitting down on the ground, just a couple, it was a really small stage, so back then I was a couple feet away from him. You could feel the sweat dripping on you.
There were lots of kids there and they could sing. They sang along.
It was really intense for me just because it was my brother up there doing what he loves and singing and playing guitar, and the music, like it almost, it was so intense it almost made you want to cry.
That's the first time I met Connie, Tom's mom, and we both stood in the back and just shook our heads and said, wow, what a wonderful thrill for them to be able to do this.
All we wanted to do was be able to headline Soma, and so being able to do that, have it actually come true, was like the best thing.
Now we're going to go off and look at our van,
the place where we lived. Ate, slept, and went to the bathroom on each other.
We were never really ambitious to get a recording contract. We just wanted to record music somehow. We were pretty much funding everything ourselves and getting everything going. And then Cargo Records stepped in and said, hey, we'll put out your first CD.
And we decided we got our independent label that we're on to co-sign for us. We went out and got this van. Every band has their van, and we had ours.
This is the old Blink van. Let's see if we can still open it. We used to sleep in here and eat fast food, and man, it's just dirty and disgusting. It really is.
A running Blink joke for a while was the Tom's glow-in-the-dark trick that Mark and Tom worked out together, and Mark would say, hey, you know, let me show you my my glow-in-the-dark trick, and everybody was sitting there, and you know, they'd turn the lights off. You'd kind of hear Tom sort of moving around a little bit, and he'd go, oh, wait, you know what, it's not working, turn the lights back on. And you know, some poor soul in the bus would have Mark's wiener about this far away from his face.
But this is the Blink van. If you want to buy it,
it doesn't work.
It doesn't run anymore.
It stinks and it's dirty, but we'll
and it's infested
it.
With spiders. Let's go back on the road. We're taking now to the place where Blink-182 actually does all of its songwriting and arranging and demoing and everything. It's a place in Escondido called DML Studios. So this is DML Studios. This is where we demoed and wrote Enema of the State, and where we're going to demo and write the next horrible catastrophe that we're going to call a record. You know, the majesty of art that's gone on in this disgustingly stinking room.
Let's just breathe for them. This is where we create.
Well, this is the Studio B. This is where all the songs are actually written. Travis sits over there and just kind of shakes his head and goes, oh God, how am I going to fix this song?
Travis played in a band that was on tour with us.
I was in a band called the Aquabats at the time.
And we needed a drummer because there was an emergency. Our drummer had to fly home.
So I had to learn all the songs like an hour or two before a show.
I remember we had to run to the music store and buy these little wooden sticks so it wouldn't be loud. So we'd play in the backstage room while the other opening bands were playing. He learned all the songs in 45 minutes and came out and played them so perfect.
Played like the next two shows.
And then after that, we needed a new drummer. And we're just like, well, who? We had three people in mind, but the one person that we had in mind of one of them was Travis, because we liked him a lot, and he already filled in, he already knew a lot of songs, and he was a big fan.
Mark and Tom were just super cool, easy to be in a band with, so I love the music, everything.
So we asked him, and he said yes, and the rest is history.
And then MCA and all these other labels came calling, and you know, we definitely wanted to take our band to the next level. So we went and we met with the people at MCA, and you know, they understood that we wanted to control our own destiny.
And then I'm like, Dad, we signed to a big label. He's like, okay. He's like, not getting, you know? And then I showed him, and I brought him a gold record, and that was like the big thing. I think then he realized. And then I'm like, Dad, I'm buying a house. He's all, huh? You know?
I was driving down the road, and I heard them being played on the radio. What's my age again? And I rolled down my window and I just wanted to scream out the window, that's my boy, that's my boy.
I don't know if we ever really came together, but if we ever came together, this would be the place where Blink-182 came together to write the songs.
And the winner is Blink-182. All the
small things. Thanks a lot, we appreciate it.
Thank you.
It's so hard to say like why Enema of the State did so well compared to the other records.
We wrote that entire album in 2 weeks, so we didn't really go in like setting out to go like, yeah, we're gonna write hits or songs that'll be popular on the radio. It wasn't like that.
I think there's so many bands that are like, yeah, yeah, we sold all these records. They expect it.
And they think they deserve it, you know. And a lot of these bands haven't put in the time to work, and we have. And so, I mean, maybe we're more grateful for it.
This is my Graceland. Son of a bitch.
This is your Graceland? All right, this was DML. This is where we recorded all of our stuff, wrote songs, made the whole world sing together.
Probably the most important piece of Blink history is a little Spanish-Mexican restaurant called Sombrero. It's just a little hole-in-the-wall Mexican restaurant, and back in the day, and even now, we eat it pretty much constantly. It's our favorite restaurant in San Diego. She'll have the bean, rice, and cheese burrito with a bottle of water.
Okay. Nice.
And for the gentleman, a bean, rice, and cheese burrito. Yummy meal. Sometimes kids leave letters and whatnot here for us.
We do have that.
Really?
We do, really?
Yeah. Let's see what's in here.
That's kind of creepy.
I hope it's naked pictures. I hope they're naked. We're kind of known for loving this restaurant, and so kids leave stuff for us here because they know that we come all the time. When we're recording, every single day we stop by Sombrero and get a bunch of food before we head into the studio to record. And then we just fart all day long.
Well, let's go sit down.
Mm. Thank you.
Mm. Yeah, we wrote a song where there's this idealistic, perfect girlfriend who lets you hang out with your friends. She's always there for you. But most importantly of all, she brings you burritos from Sombrero.
I'll try and eat the second burrito, but just because it's on TV, not because
I'm... No, try and put the whole thing in your mouth. I got this big package from our fans, and I'm gonna call them up and say thank you. They're young, they're in junior high. Do you think it's creepy at all that an older man is calling hi? Hey, Bree, this is Tom and Mark from Blink-182. We just received your package here at Sombrero.
Let her know that she's named after a type of cheese.
Yeah, Mark says your name is after a type of cheese. Brie cheese is quite good if you eat it with crackers and grapes, he says. But hey, thank you for your package. Sorry that we just got it. I think you left it months ago. All right, thanks, bye.
Now that I have a big gut full of beans, we're gonna try and go play a show, and I'll try and not fall down because I'm so gut heavy right now.
The secret location for the secret Blink-182 concert is the Empire Room here in North Park, San Diego.
Hi! Come here. Do you have my name written on you at all? Or just Tom?
She's the one that's in love with you.
Oh, are you in love with me?
Yes.
Why? Do you have a thing for ugly, fat, disgusting guys?
No, yeah. I have a thing for very cute, talented guys.
Oh, well, then you should like Travis. Hey, you guys. Hi. You guys?
For this show, it'll be all their friends, all their family, and nobody really else, so it'll be exclusively for them.
Look at that, mamas!
Yeah. I thought you wanted like several years ago.
Brian, I don't know if you guys know this, is actually on the back of our very first CD called Cheshire Cat. Here's Brian and all his glory. Cam was the very first roadie that we ever had. Cam tuned guitars, hauled gear, sold merchandise, settled shows.
For 20 bucks a day.
We're just moments away from taking the stage and making total asses out of ourselves.
They're gonna laugh at us. They're all gonna laugh at us.
Let's go.
Game on.
Welcome, family and friends, the people who think they're friends. It's gonna be really fun. I don't want to cuss because my mom's here.
Hey, my mom's here. Give it up for my mom. Give it up for my mom.
Every time there's a local show within a few hours, I'm there to watch it.
Tom's sister Carrie, where's she at? Carrie, come here, please. Carrie, honestly, what do you
think? Oh, we're gonna have to embarrass her. You know what we're gonna do?
We're gonna play another song now.
Conspiracies are dumb.
love playing in our hometown, but I also find playing in our hometown kind of more nerve-wracking. You have your family and you have your friends, you have people you actually care about their opinion. But at the same time, it's comforting to know that they come and support you.
I think everyone's a little bit more like nervous when we play, just because it is hometown. We definitely have like the bugs in our stomach when we come to San Diego, you know?
When we're on tour, all I think about is coming home and hanging out. This is where all my friends are, this is where I feel at home, and this is where I feel comfortable.
I'm sober.
Our van.
Remember when we used to have to poop in it?
No, I don't remember that part.
I poop in it. I poop in the back.
What's the deal with 182?
It's a secret what that means.
It means nothing.
Ow! Oh!
For more on Blink 182, log on to MTV.com.